Welcome back. In next video, part second, as we know, book is going on, Anish Pom, lesson number one, three questions, which is written by Leo Tolstoy. Okay, so second part we are going to start. The king turned round and saw a bearded man running towards them. His hands were pressed against his stomach from which blood was flowing. When he reached the king, he fainted and fell to the ground. The king and the hermit removed the man's clothing and found a large wound in his stomach. The king washed and covered it with his handkerchief, but the blood would not stop flowing. The king redressed the wound until at last the bleeding stopped. So exactly what happened? Hermit and king, both are talking to each other. Exactly, a person is running towards them and he was wounded. Exactly, he pressed his hand on his stomach, okay, because the blood was flowing. Anybody stabbed him. So when he reached the king, fainted. When he reached to the king, he fainted and fell down. So king and hermit removed the man's clothing. This type of cloth, who has worn this cloth removed, and there was a large wound in his stomach. The king washed and covered. King washed his wound and covered with the handkerchief. And finally he redressed. Redressed means to cover, to clean, and to cover this by the simple cloth and usable cloth which is used for the wound. Okay, so wound until at last the bleeding stopped. The man felt better and asked for something to drink. Okay, so sometime after, man felt better and he asked for a drinking water. The king brought fresh water and gave it to him. So king gave him a water. Gave him water. By this time, the sun had set and the air was cool. At the time, it was the time of evening. Okay, sun has set and air was cool. The king with the hermit's help carried the wounded man into the hut and laid him on the bed. Both carried him and laid him on the bed. Okay. The man closed his eyes and lay quietly. The king, tired by his walk and the work he had done, which work has been done by the king, he was so tired. So he lay down also on the floor, slept through the night. Whole night he was sleeping because he was tired. When he awoke, it was several minutes before he could remember. What he remembered? When he awoke, he remembered. What he remembered? Where he was, or who the strange bearded man lying on the bed was. It's me. King was thinking, when he got up, he thought, who is this person who is laying on the bed? And he has a long bearded. Forgive me, said the bearded man in a weak voice. When he saw that the king was awake. What happened? It's me, bearded man, excused. Forgive me. When he saw the king has awakened. Okay, I don't know. You and have nothing to forgive you for, said the king. King said, I don't know. For what purpose are you demanding excuse? Why are you telling me, forgive me, what you have done? You do not know me, who said. Bearded man said, you don't know me, but I know you. I am that enemy of yours who swore revenge on you. I am your enemy and I have taken oath. Taken oath means swore. I have swore that I will take revenge to you because you put my brother to death and seized my property. Because you have declared to kill my brother as a punishment, and you seized my property. I knew you had gone alone to see that hermit, and I know very well that you are going to see the hermit, and I have a chance to kill you. And I made up my mind to kill you on your way home. And when you will come back and you will return to your home, that time I will kill you, I decided. But exactly the day passed and you did not return. After some days you are staying here, you did not go back, you did not return at your home. So I left my hiding place and I came upon your bodyguard, who recognized me and wounded me. I escaped from him, but I should have died if you had not dressed my wounds. So I decided to kill you, but exactly your bodyguard saw me and they wounded me, and when I came here, so you dressed me, you saved my life. I wished to kill you and you have saved my life. So what was the difference of thinking? I wished that I want to kill you, and your wish that you saved my life. Now, if I will, I will serve you as your most faithful servant and will order my son to do the same. Forgive me. Please, my Lord, forgive me. I will be your servant and I will give order to my son also. He will be servant for you forever. Please forgive me. The king was very happy to have made peace with his enemy so easily and to have won him over as a friend. He not only forgave him but said he would send his servants and his own doctor to look after him, and he promised to give back the man his property. So when the king saved him and the bearded man excused him forgave, he was demanding forgiveness, and finally king forgave him, and thereafter king sent a doctor, a personal doctor, to look after him, and some servant has been sent to the bearded man to look after him. Okay, next. And king promised that I will return your old property. Leaving the wounded man, the king went out of the hut and looked around for the hermit. Before going away, he wished once more to get answer to his questions. After saying these things, the king went out and he was seeking the hermit. He went to hermit and he thought, before going to home, finally, last time I should ask once again this question. If he will reply, so I will be happy, otherwise I will go to home. The hermit was on his knees sowing seeds in the beds that had been dug the day before. The king went up to the hermit and said, for the last time, I beg you to answer my questions wisely. When the king saw him, the wise man, that means the hermit, was sowing seeds. Okay, means he was planting the plants with the seeds. Okay, so king reached there and asked once again that if you don't mind, so finally I am going to home, and please reply my questions answer. You have already been answered, said the hermit, still bending down to the ground and looking up at the king as he stood before him. So hermit said, king, exactly you have got your answers. How have I been answered? What do you mean? King said, what do you mean, hermit? How can I get? And how have I been answered? Exactly tell me. Do you not see? Replied the hermit. Means, do you not see what happened with you? You did not learn anything. What happened with you yesterday? If he had not pitied my weakness yesterday and had not dug these beds for me, you would have gone away. If you had not done this work, whatever you were doing yesterday, so you had gone home away. Exactly. Then that man would have attacked you and you would have wished you had stayed with me. if you had gone to home yesterday, so that man, bearded man, definitely attacked you and maybe you might have killed. But you stayed here. You stayed here for some days, and you were working with me, and it is. So the most important time was when you were digging the pits. So what was the important time to start anything? The question was this: what was the right time to start anything? So that was your right time to start anything, means start digging the pits or digging the pits. So it was the right time. Okay, first answer you have got. And I was the most important man, and to do me good was your most important business. And I was the right man. I was to important person to whom you are to listen. And to do me good was your most important business. Afterwards, when the man ran to us, the most important time was when you were caring for him. And last question, your last question was, what was the right time? Your last question was, what is the most important thing for him to do? So your last question, according to your last question, your last answer is there. You are caring of him, caring of the bearded man. It was your important time for doing anything. Okay, next. If you had not raised his goods, he would have died without having made peace with you. If you have not wounded and did redressed his wounds, so definitely he had died. And you saved his life. So that means you have got some peace. So he was the most important man, and what you did for him was your most important business. So he was the most important person, and whatever you have done with him, that was your most important business. Remember, then there is only one time that is important, and that time is now. It is the most important time because it is the only time we have any power to do. Exactly at the time where you are at the time, and it is the time is your right time for doing anything. So remember always, at the time or any time if you are doing anything, that is the right time to do for you. The most necessary person is the person you are with at the particular moment. The most important person who is with whom you are doing anything, with whom you are talking, with whom you are doing any work. For no one knows what will happen in the future and whether we will meet anyone else. And nobody knows about the future. You will meet me or meet you, any one person, ever or not. The most important business is to do that person good, because we were sent into this world for that purpose alone. So the most important business is to do that person is good. It's mean whatever you are doing at the time, that is the right time, with whom you are talking or doing anything, that is the right person. And at last, we have been sent in this world for that purpose alone. Means we have been sent in this world for the important purpose. We are to get this purpose, we are to know about this purpose, and we are to complete these things. Okay, so once at last, I would like to say you, please consider your study, okay, and revise these things, whatever I have taught you. If you have any doubts, so comment. And this questions answer PDF file will be sent soon. Thank you.